sanatoria stanno andando piano piano sulla coronavirus. E la gente che hanno fatto questa domanda della sanatoria, bisogna una risposta. Non so se c'hai qualcosa da dire o qualcosa da spiegare in questo punto.
Allora, purtroppo ne so quanto te, perché sono un avvocato, non lavoro per il ministero o nelle prefetture. E anche io ho letto gli articoli che hai letto tu. C'è scritto che hanno chiamato pochissime persone per la firma, alcune prefetture non hanno ancora chiamato proprio nessuno. Mentre in altre città hanno cominciato a chiamare qualche domanda, ma stanno andando molto molto lenti. Per esempio, c'è scritto che le prefetture che fissano gli appuntamenti fissano 10 appuntamenti al giorno. Quindi se
Certo.
tu devi guardare 2.000 domande, 3.000 domande, 10 appuntamenti al giorno ci vorrà tantissimo tempo.
Alright guys, welcome back to Prince TV. If this is your first time of coming across to this platform, please guys, don't forget to hit that red subscribe button so that you can be getting my updates. Anytime when you be like say I post my video, you go see how it happens. So make you try to subscribe and then you put your notification bell make for the see how it the play. Alright, this video is to give analysis what we did with the lawyer known as Paola Obinati di Remini, because I know most of you are keeping question on my Instagram, different kind of question. This is because you guys did not watch this video. Try to watch this video on the board you are seeing here. At the end of the video, try to watch this particular video and get all your questions you were asking, because that day when we made that a video, the lady answered a lot of questions. Many guys were throwing questions up and down, left, right, and center. And then this lady was reading, me myself, I was still reading on the question to ask her, and then she replied these questions. And then most of the questions which people are pumping on my Instagram and that of WhatsApp has been answered in this video, because you guys did not watch that video. That is why you find it difficult to understand everything. Anything when it be like soon as they ask about the document issue, different kind of thing, cassazione, asilo, this asilo ritirata, many kind of question. Even the sanatorial issue, many things this lady explained for that video. But I can discover, say, most people not go watch the video, may they see how it happened. Now, the problem when make it, like, say, the question now, come for the WhatsApp, people call the paro, so I know they reply them for inside the WhatsApp. Now, I wish to make this video to answer most of the question. First, the woman stated that those ones who have 2 years documents, that they can go to their country straight, that is humanitarian documents or special protection, because you did not qualify to get the political asyl document. At the same time, you did not qualify to have the subsidiary document. So these two types of documents are the documents which you cannot travel direct to your country. Asyl political, known as refugee status, and that of the subsidiary document. This is one of the things this lady stated as well. One person asked this question. I think your question has been answered. Now, if you realize, say, you get the 2 years document, when be the humanitarian or special protection, you go feel use that one buy tickets direct from here to Italy, straight to your country, whether Ghana, Gambia, Nigeria, anywhere you for take on, you feel go straight to your country with that one. So get it in mind. That is a part. Now, let me explain the one of asilo ritirata, what the lady stated there, because this video is not as if I'm trying to kind of like, you guys are giving me stress on this particular video because we did everything already. On the asilo ritirata, she stated that those ones who will be going for this asilo ritirata, that, you know, the commission will determine if they are going to give that person negative or not. And at the end of the day, if they give that person negative and then put that inadmissibility, most of you who are watching me know when we are explaining these things. If they put that inadmissibility, stating that you cannot renew that permit to the sojourner, then you have to take a lawyer or find a lawyer who will go and then fight this case for you. At that point, the lawyer have to ask the judge to remove that inadmissibility in order for you to renew your permit to the sojourner to remain regular. It is very much important. Because if, for example, you cannot renew your permit to the sojourner, tomorrow you get opportunity of work. Without your permit, you no go fit work that work. That is to say, you go work in Nero. And Oyibo people, most of them this time around, the rate at which the Italian government are disturbing the police, they are scared of taking immigrants in Nero. So that is one thing you have to understand. So if it happens to be you are in the category of those ones who they did not allow to renew the permit to the sojourner, It is advisable immediately to take a lawyer and then book the case, because this lawyer will at the same time try to make a recourse and then file in that they need approval for you to be able to renew your permit with the sojourner. So when the judge cross-check and see everything, the filing of the case, how the issue is, the new evidence, the judge will now determine to print out A4 size. I explained this thing many times, but many people, they ask the question, maybe not the new ones, maybe like say they join this platform. When this judge prints out this A4 size, then it will send it back to your lawyer. Then the lawyer now will not give you that A4 size to questura. That particular paper, the judge have already stated that they should suspend that inadmissibility which they give you, inadmissibility to renew your permit with the sojourner. Then at that point, if you renew the permit with the sojourner, you are okay. Then you get audiencia for tribunal. That is for asilo retirata. Now let's go to the one of the cassazione. I asked this lady a question based on the new decreto di sicurezza which the Conte government have changed. What is the hope of those ones who are under cassazione, that is the Supreme Court? Now this lady stated that, you know, the cassazione don't have much say on people's documents, that all they have to do is to check the reason why the judge did not give you the documents at the first place, referring you to cassazione. If the reason is not tangible enough, then the cassazione will not send send a letter to your lawyer, and then the lawyer will not bring the case back to tribunal to check and know the reason why they did not give you document. That is to say, the cassazione, you have already won that place, stating that they have to go back to tribunal and review this case, that this person wants to receive documents. And then the judge have to check everything. And then mind you, at this point, the judge still have another opportunity to give his or her enemy negative. We don't pray for that. So for those ones who are making a cassazione, you should have it in mind that your case will be reviewed again in the court of a tribunal. And then that is where they are going to grant you your document. So this is one of the things we were stating in that particular video, whereby most of you are asking the same question, similar question on my Instagram. So if you still have questions to ask, maybe I did not explain the part you want, you can keep it at the comment section of this video. I'll try my best as possible to reply you guys. So that is one thing you have to understand. And I still try to ask this lady that, you know, we have heard that in the article of the Decreto di Sicurezza, we state that those ones who have been integrated in the country, that they are eligible to have the special protection as the law has stated. And then this lady come out with a point stating that, you know, it is possible, but they still need your story. They still need evidence based on your story back home, what you have done, all those kind of stuff, so that you can be able to obtain this special protection. So now have it in mind that, you know, not only that you have worked here in Italy, you have gone to school, you have do one or two things, you still have to put more evidence on your story to compile together in order to obtain that special protection. This is what you guys have to know based on this issue. I think this video have to be something short, because I just have to summarize this issue here so that people can know how all these things are going. If you have not subscribed to this platform, please guys, try to subscribe. This evening I'll be dropping a video and see how things are going here in Italy. Next time again, we'll be together. Ciao.
Quindi, l'umanitaria può essere, se lavori la converti in lavoro, se non lavori può essere rinnovata se la commissione dà parere positivo, non è automatico.
Non è automatico. Ok, guys, I hope you guys understand what... Ok, I know most of you already understand what she's explaining. It's just good for me to kind of like keep a little bit and translate for people who cannot really understand where, even me myself, I'm still learning Italian. We all are learning here in Italy, you know, little by little, we get everything right. Now, what she's trying to explain in this point is that the humanitarian document, because there is somebody who asked question, what is the advantage or and then disadvantage of this humanitarian protection document, which is now known as special protection. Then at this point, she was trying to explain that the humanitarian protection is a document which is being issued at when you are not qualified for this political asylum document or that of the subsidiary document. And then now, having this document, you guys know that already, you can convert it to motive of work, you can use it to get a passport, all those kind of stuff. Then the bad aspect of it, which is the disadvantage, what she's trying to explain at that point, was that, you know, that same humanitarian document can still be checked when you go to renew. Let me say, for example, if you put it on maybe for working, then you have the possibility to be using it for work. But if you don't have work and then you go back to renew this humanitarian protection known as special protection, there is a high possibility for them to review the case and know if you still have the kind of like ability or have the kind of like a qualification to still hold that document since you are not working with it. So my own point of view or my own kind of like what I see in this issue, what you just stated, is that if you have a humanitarian protection or special protection, it's advisable you convert it to work. So if you go to renew, they see that now you are working and then you are eligible to renew this document since you are paying tax to the government. And then I think you are kind of like a welcome to stay in the country. But those ones who be going to renew your permit to the sojourner humanitarian, that is special protection, without a contract of work, is a little bit in form of a risk. You understand? Because they have to check if they can still give you back this permit. This is what she's just trying to explain in this particular point. So guys, try to pump in your question. Your question determines how this video will go. You understand? So try to keep your questions. We answer all the questions one by one. Ho già spiegato a loro.
No, hai spiegato benissimo. E vorrei anche aggiungere una cosa. Il tuo consiglio è giusto. Se hai un'umanitaria e stai lavorando, il consiglio giusto è convertila, così hai converti il lavoro. Se invece quando scade l'umanitaria sei sfortunato e non stai lavorando, il consiglio giusto è tu chiedi lo stesso di rinnovare l'umanitaria. Se va tutto bene te la rinnovano. Se per caso ti dicono di no, comunque tu puoi lo stesso a quel punto tornare davanti a un giudice e chiedere di riguardare tutte le carte. Quindi se tu lavori converti, ma se per caso non lavori, tu vai avanti lo stesso a chiedere il rinnovo e se ti dicono di no, vai di nuovo davanti a un giudice.